Possibly the greatest scientific advance in all of man's history took place at Alamogordo, New Mexico, on the morning of July 16, 1945. Yet the man whose theory of relativity was directly responsible for its occurrence, Albert Einstein, was once quoted as saying that if he had his life to live over, he would choose to be a plumber. One of the most brilliant minds the world has ever known died at Princeton Hospital at the age of 76. When his relativity theory was completed in 1921, the scientific world hailed it as perhaps the greatest achievement in the history of human thought. He gave the world atomic energy with the warning that annihilation of every breath of life on Earth was now within the range of the technical possibilities of man. Albert Einstein, the Isaac Newton of the 20th century, truly one of the great men of our time.
That I never met Einstein. If you are still alive, I would do everything in my power to meet him. Einstein teaches me about love as well as the science. Passion, love, and science. I love Albert Einstein.
Looking for Einstein Brain.
Okay. How long do you plan to stay in the United States?
Maybe 1 month or over 1 month.
Okay.
はじめまして。Sugimoto です。
Einstein Brains in Princeton. I'd hope there is Einstein Brain in Princeton. I want Einstein Brains in Princeton.
うわ、これ。うわ、これ。 So please, where is one Einstein Brain? Which one Einstein Brain? Please show me.
Oh, those are the brains that we have over here.
Albert Einstein?
No. Sorry. We don't have it.
Chotto okashii na.
All right. So we need the autopsy report for 1955. There we go. Go on. 1955, 59. Okay, let me go back up a little bit here. Stop. Number 1955-32. Patient died on April 15th. Now Einstein died about the 18th, I believe. 32, and here we see it goes right to 34. And this is on the 18th, April 18th. So 33 is missing.
Which was Einstein's.
Which should have been Einstein's. Number 33. So it goes from 32, skips, goes to 34, and then on to 35. So Einstein's autopsy is missing from our files. Well, Dr. Harvey did the autopsy on number 33. Einstein's autopsy. So maybe Dr. Harvey has it. Maybe some other administrator has that file.
That's a mystery. A mystery. Nobody's looked for it. Nobody has looked for it for 20 years. All of a sudden, you people come and want to have good answers to good questions. And we look and we find no records.
What happened to Einstein's brain?
The brain was kept by Dr. Harvey, mm-hmm. and he was had agreed to study it, get expert help with the study of the brain, mm-hmm. and then publish his findings. Uh-huh. And that became a controversy at the hospital because the administrator of the hospital kept saying to Dr. Harvey, when are you going to publish the report of the Einstein brain? And Dr. Harvey would say, well, when I get time for it.
Oh, yes.
Mm. In the fall of 1960, Dr. Harvey was fired, dismissed from his position at the hospital by Mr. Kaufman, the administrator. And the most notable reason for that was he had failed to publish a report on the Einstein brain.
During my stay in America, I wished to see Einstein's brain. Is it possible for me to see Einstein's brain?
Oh, no. You see, when Dr. Harvey left Princeton, mm-hmm. he was the owner of the Einstein brain, so he took the Einstein brain with him, and for a while it was in outside of Princeton at his office.
The professor was wondering what is the best way to pursue further about the